this slide, it basically is a grammar, any grammar. This is, see, this formal language and automata theory, one thing we have started, the models of computation. Models of computation, most basic form of model of computation is finite state machine. Within finite state machine, what is the most basic is the combinatorial circuit. The combinatorial circuit is, there is no feedback path like your on and off switch, or you make a b c d, any combination of NOT gate and gate and something. That is a combinatorial circuit. That is the most fundamental computational block. Then if we have a D type flip flop and we make a register counter, that is also in the same grade, that is called basic finite state machine. And that machine is called deterministic finite state machine. We'll see it, that it is corresponds to one and only regular language. Then what is regular language? Regular language is nothing but, you all know, like whenever you find command in Unix, L start dot c, these are, star means any wildcard thing. This is nothing but a regular language. So here you star, you cannot mention one items or two items or three items, it's a star. So anyway, these basic form automata and formal language, one is your automata and you have a one-to-one corresponding language. The all language can be like your finite state machine has five tuple, here grammar is four tuple. So what is four tuple? V is the variables. That means it generally written in capital letter A, B, C, D. It is ultimately reduced to terminals. And what are terminals? Terminals are nothing but within your sigma, the which are the like our digital 01 or smaller case A, B, C, D. So this is, V is the set of variables. Sigma is your, already you know the finite state machine, the terminals. P is the set of production rules, the which rule, like noun clause and verb clause, then noun clause have noun and adverb, verb clause has some verb and adverb, like we English language, how we can speak infinite combination. So we follow grammar. So this is, F is nothing but a grammar, and S is the start symbol. S is similarly, if your finite state machine is a Q0, here S is that, it is a variable. Everything start from S, and these are the valid production rules. And here we'll see our regular language, the grammar is like this, like coming to next. And who else this done this is Noam Chomsky, a great scientist, till now he is living, his age is 93. He has done it single-handedly, this language formation. Yeah, see here, we are basically in a type 3 grammar. It is called regular grammar, and it is for all finite state machine. And I have already told my last two class, lecture 5 and lecture 6, that this is the variable, capital, and right hand side is a string. It consists of a terminal variable. So what is the type 3 grammar is? It can, left hand side should be always a variable, one variable, and right hand side a single terminal or another variable. Then we call, is because it's the end of right side, this is called right linear grammar, or it can be if the B comes before, that's called left linear grammar. But this is a first fundamental block of programming languages. Like whenever you are writing a identifier, like identifier in any programming language, in Python, Java, it starts with a alphabetic character, and then in any letters and alphabets. So that's it. That is by regular expression. I have covered in my last class. You just see it. So anyway, any grammar, this is type 3 grammar. It can be determined, it can be computed by the finite state machine. Then we'll go for type 2 grammar. Type 2 grammar is left hand side can be a variable, right hand side any damn thing. No ordering is required. It can be variable, terminal, variable, anything. Then it's called context free grammar, and that context free grammar is, you have to be determined by deterministic push down automata. That means your finite state machine is not sufficient, you need a stack into this, that is called push down. Then come the context sensitive grammar. Then your left hand side cannot be singular, it can have any partner with it, that is, that can be done by a Turing machine. We will solve it. in later on. So basically this course is your fundamental type of computing hardware and how to titillate that hardware, how to excite the hardware with the language. So this is 1:1 type 3 grammar and regular grammar, deterministic finite state machine, non-deterministic finite state machine, all are same. That is the great thing we learn with this next 1 or 2 classes. So a language is a regular language of some finite automata, recognize it. So this is a fantastic statement from Michael Sifser. So if you have a deterministic finite state machine, it can only cater one and only regular language, not subset and supersetting. So every finite state machine, you can minimize the number of states. Yeah, that can be done. A finite state machine may have 10 states. You can minimize, we will know how to minimize the techniques. But once it is minimized, it cannot be further minimized, and it can cater only one and only one regular language. That's great. Yeah, it is basically a language, and you can call it a problem also. So our regular language comes here and here is a deterministic context tree where you need a stack. Like a to the power n, b to the power n language, you can say a to the power, you have to count a to the power n, count a and count b. If you say I count with finite state machine, but if I say 100, I say more than 101, you will fall short to count a. So there is always a stack infinite. So whenever a to the power n is there, I push them into the stack, infinite stack, and whenever b is coming, I pop a. And whenever the string is finished, left to right, when the string is finished, your pushed A, there is no pushed A, and B is finished. So that is your matching. But in finite state machine, you cannot compare A to the power N, B to the power N language. You can compare A to the power N, B, or A to the power M, B to the power N. That language can be done. There is no relation between M and N. That can be done by regular language. But when there is a to the power N and B to the power N, whenever you see the N are equal, how to measure the N is equal? You need a stack to measure it. Okay. If there is no relation between A to the power M and B to the power N, no relation between M and N, then it can be done by finite state machine. But whenever you say M is greater than N or N is must be less than N, then you have to maintain relation, then you need a stack, like a common balance in physics lab. So you need a more higher grade of machine, then you call a pushdown automata. That is a tougher machine. But let's concentrate on regular language, and regular language is say A to the power M, B to the power N is a regular language, A to the power N, B regular language. These are the regular languages, and these are the more higher type of languages. These languages are required for better complexity. I will learn. Okay, this is grammar classification. I say already type 3 grammar. I have already told about type 3 grammar, and I already discussed the basic fundamental things is the deterministic finite state machine, and they are equivalent. So first, type 3 grammar and deterministic finite state machine are equivalent. And another great thing is deterministic finite state machine goes in every next kind of machine, like pushdown automata. Their heart is again a deterministic finite state machine. Extra hardware is a single stack. Okay, then we'll go to the Turing machine also again a deterministic finite state machine, and the head is not only read head and write head, it can go left and right. So that is it. So we cannot escape deterministic finite state machine, because that is the heart of your computer, heart of your CPU design, because that deterministic finite state machine is everywhere, not only to recognize regular languages, but also deterministic pushdown automata, that is for context-free grammar, deterministic context-free grammar, non-deterministic context-free grammar. You need a stack and also a deterministic finite state machine, and even a Turing machine is a deterministic finite state machine with a read head and extra write head, and it can go left and right and like this. So it is everywhere. So how we make a deterministic finite state machine understand best, then you can understand the subsequent design issues of all the further languages. That I already covered to you. This is a type 3 language. Now I make clear this is type 3. Why type 3? Because here this side always say type 3 and type 2 grammar, left hand side should be singular. So it is single variable, this is called variable, no state, this is variable, this is start variable, and right hand side a variable, these are right linear grammar, and this is alphabet. I covered. Next go to this. I already covered my lecture 6. Next go, I think another thing I wish to cover today's class. This I have taken it from Michael Sifser book. If you have any query, you can ask me right now. Remember, F is a subset, is maybe proper subset of Q, or it will be full, or it may be F is equal to Q. Then F is equal to Q, then all are accepting state. Then you see your language will be sigma star. Generally, F is less than Q. Okay, it's a subset, proper subset of Q. And that's it. This I have covered. You see the Michael Sifser's book. This is I have already covered. This is a delta transition function. Formal definition of computation I have told. Next thing I wish to cover, this one I have not covered it. Yeah, this is Michael Sifser's book. It's a finite automata. This I have already covered. This is from the Dexter Cordson, ultimately all are same. I wish to show they are same. That is the reason I took the definition from different, one of the best books in industry, and show they are basically same. Any one book, if you find it good, is good. Here I have told it again and again, the regular language, finite automata, they are basically all are 1:1 relationship. Any one finite automata, one regular language, one regular grammar. What is regular grammar? Regular expression, like I have told you, any variable starts with a letter and it can have a letter and digit. So this is the diagram, this is the regular expression. Whenever you see it here with the star, whenever you say plus, that means one or more occurrence, and star means zero or more occurrence. So this is a regular expression. I have told it, this is regular expression you have always see in various Linux command. This is very very interesting diagram in Michael Sifser. Please follow this. This is excellent, one of the best diagram. The deterministic computation is always deterministic. Okay, it either accept or reject. And non-deterministic computation, it go anywhere. It go hundreds way. But if one of it is accepted, we'll say it is accepted. So designing non-deterministic computation on paper is easier. On paper, to create a state diagram in non-deterministic computation on paper, it is very easier, but very very difficult on actual hardware. So ultimately all are actual hardware by deterministic computation, but non-deterministic computation is easier to design on paper, because from regular expression to non-deterministic computation sometimes easier, sometimes always easier, sometimes easier. So and here it is kind of a OR gate. If any of the path is accepted, if nothing is accepted, then do not accept. The language is not accepted. But if there is the only one accept, we'll say language is accepted. But it is unrealizable in hardware. This is, I have told you, two different kinds of non-deterministic finite automata is there. One is with epsilon transition. In some books it is called lambda transition. Epsilon lambda means it is actually no transition, but it transition. Like, you don't get any symbol, but it can jump, like Schrodinger wave equation. From Q1 to Q2, it can jump on anything, on epsilon. Epsilon is no symbol at all. It is kind of a null concept, so it's difficult to understand, but try to. Non-deterministic finite automata, again two type. One is from Q with A, we go from this state or this state. So, and there is no probability, and also epsilon, you can go into state. So both can be there. In non-deterministic finite automata can have, in deterministic automata it is not possible. With only one symbol you can jump to one state. But non-deterministic finite state machine with on symbol you can jump many state one, and you can jump with epsilon also. Yes, so that is the formal definition, and you definitely remember your sigma now consists of epsilon or lambda, and this is a power set, and it can jump anywhere. So this is a power set, the transition function. This is one interesting example I wish to show you. Yeah, this is from Michael. This is not covered in lecture 6. This is now lecture 7. This, please, you get it through Michael Sipse's book. The book is with you. This is what kind of automata it is. Definitely 0, 1 and even 1. That definitely is a non-deterministic automata. Okay. Again, it can go 0 with epsilon. So it is not only non-deterministic finite automata with epsilon transition also. So this diagram looks innocuous, but it is a NFA. It is not DFA. How can understand it is an NFA? Because with 1, it can be Q1 and it can be Q2. And because if from Q2 to Q3, you can go to epsilon, so it is a NFA. Okay, fine. The formal description of N1 is like this, NQ, and this is your transition diagram. Remember, say here, interesting, with Q1, with 1, you can go to Q1 or Q2. So Q1 with 1, you can go Q1 to Q2. So Q1 and Q2 is a power set. So this is Q1 and combination, this is a power set. So in fact, whenever you are converting this non-deterministic automata to deterministic automata, this is a new set. Q1, Q2 make a capital Q3 sort of set. Okay, this is a new Q1. We cannot take, so all the state whatever is there in non-deterministic finite automata, whenever you wish to convert to deterministic finite state machine, states will be all changed. Okay, even the this state, you might argue, say it is a simple Q1. No, it is not that. In deterministic finite state machine, that Q1 is that Q1 different. So we make it a capital Q1. Here, in Q1 and Q2, we make it a capital Q2. Okay, and the Q3, capital Q3. Okay, Q4 is capital Q4, and because Q4 is the accepting state, so whichever states are Q4 are there is the accepting states. So that is our drawing of the of our conversion from non-deterministic NFA to deterministic NFA. That is a typical problem will come in a class test, in a quiz, all these things. Now I'm open, please have a question.